From BYU Broadcasting's performance studio, this is Highway 89. I'm Stephen Cap Perry. Right after getting a college degree in the Rocky Mountains, a quick car ride away from the town where she grew up, Wrenne wandered away from home to take a job as a nanny in the UK. But that was 15 years ago, and she has been there ever since. And she is not nannying anymore. Now she's got a team of designers, producers, and other creatives supporting her ever-expanding musical ideas. Trying to pin down a notion of what to expect when you see Wrenne on stage is a little tricky. Her own website describes her in bites. Utah child, period. UK artist. Electronic truth catcher, storyteller, collaborator, runner, mother, it says. She's putting the finishing touches on a stage show that's part music, part trampoline art, part costume, part dance. The show is called I Said Yes to Everything, which is maybe the best description of Wrenne's feelings about making art and about life. Wrenne is in our studio today, our guest. We're delighted to have her. We've got a lot of great music and conversation coming up this hour, and we'll start it off with a song. Here is All of Everything, performed by Wrenne, here on Highway 89.
A little bit of something is worth more than a whole lot of nothing. I'm not so sure. Be content with what you've got. I'm afraid to say I'm not. I want
All of Everything, coming to you live, Highway 89, Wrenne in studio. You know, when you hear recordings of your music, Wrenne, there's a lot of electropop, sometimes guest performers, including even Idris Elba. There's an interesting story, I'm sure. But
yeah,
today we are getting to hear the songs, maybe in the form where they first existed as you created them. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
So you told a story just as we were setting up, and I thought, wait, don't tell that. We want the audience to hear that about... You'd studied musical theater.
That's right.
But it was seems like it was actually getting your own guitar that revealed something about yourself to you.
That's right. So I went to London right after graduating in musical theater. And actually, it wasn't to become a nanny. It was because of my imagination. I just thought of it. I think I was looking for the edges and I wanted to go on an adventure. I actually didn't even have a plan. I found a nanny job when I got there, and I'll sing you a song later about how the kids inspired me to write music for them. My brother Josh gave me a guitar, an old backpacker's guitar that he had. He had loads of guitars just hanging around. So he gave me one that I could take, and literally in the airport on the way, I started plucking the strings. And I had never learned to play guitar before, even though my house was full of guitars and musicians. But this is when I discovered that I had songs in me. And they just spilled out, the words and the music.
What do you love either about the electronic creation or about just the purity of you and your guitar? What do you like best about each?
Well, I love that I can do both, that I have them both. That's the best part. Playing for myself, with myself, is obviously I can come here and I can sing to you and I can sing to my brother. I can sing to my cat. I can sing and listen to myself. And there's so much pleasure in all of that. The electronic music is genuinely created always through collaboration. And it's so fun to hear my music or my words or my voice in a context that I never otherwise would have.
Yeah.
And so it's just a creative process.
We're going to talk more, but of course we want as much music as we can. Tell us about these next two, Ready and Brothers Road.
Okay, so Ready is a song I wrote with Jan Rydningen in Norway. It was written for a wedding. And Brothers Road was written by my brother, Sam. When I first moved to England, I asked him to send me a song that he could write that I could sing. And it took me about 14 years to learn it. But I finally picked it up and learned it. I find so much enjoyment singing his song.
Great. We're glad to include a cover. We're listening to Wrenne. She mentioned singing to her cat. I'm just thinking it's a pretty lucky cat who gets to hear all of these songs in their stages of development. Here is Ready, followed by Brothers Road.
Stolen now from my own mind are the reasons of my wisdom. Without you here, come with me. We can go now. We have been here long enough, and I am ready. From this race I have been spent, there was nothing worth a chase till I found you for me to see. Was never so easy. We are soft from what is rough. And I am ready, I am ready. Can we go? I don't know where to, but just with you. And here I am dreaming that you take my hands, release me. I am ready. wandered far, not alone, meet my family, gazing dazed upon this place. Brother, this is where we grew, there the field where long you toiled, here the house where blood first boiled, and the road that sent me running far from you. Blue heaven, cool us down, bear away our holy load. Let us turn this sacred ground and let us walk a brother's road. Let us walk a brother's road. Is that the scar I left you then? I see it's folded now beneath deep light. You still smell the fields and pines, and I suppose I smell of where I've been. I came when first I heard. Seems funny that I shed no tears. I guess I figured he died just to bring me here, to bring me home like a wounded bird. Blue heaven, cool us down, bear away our holy load. Let us turn the sacred ground and let us walk a brother's road. Let us walk a brother's road. So lift his feet now, lift his head. Let us lay him gently in the ground, softly, softly, like the sound of everything he ever said to us. Like my mind closed up to you, let us close the earth now over him. He's returning now to where he's been, like I'm returning here anew. Blue heaven, cool us down.
This is Highway 89 coming to you live from Studio 6. A pair of tunes from Wrenne, Ready, and the cover tune Brother's Road, a song inspired by the biblical story of Jacob and Esau. We mentioned that you grew up right here in Utah, went to England to take an adventure right out of college. You make your home, as we said, for about 15 years in the UK. As a musical artist, tell us about that trajectory. Like, once you arrived, I mean, to arrive in a totally new place, it's scary enough when people say, I'm going to Nashville or I'm going to New York, but I already sort of know my way and I drive on the correct side of the road and all of that kind of stuff. Tell us a little bit about this journey into becoming an artist and finding your place there.
Yeah, well, I just honestly was just delivered into the hands of angels one by one. So I had booked myself into a hostel for 2 nights and I had like
$300. So there's
bucks.
All of future ahead, but you had planned for 2 nights. So
yeah,
got
like
that
I was
covered.
Like, I'll just get a job. And I wasn't scared. In retrospect, I can see how brave it was or how brave it seems or scary it seems. But at the time, I was just really normal. I was like, everything will be fine. I'll get a job. I've been around kids. Maybe I could nanny. This is where that came from. So my first job was to be an au pair for somebody, but only because this person called me on the, you know, I asked for this job and she was like, where are you from? What are you doing? What is it? And I told her my whole story and she's like, I'm coming to get you, because she knew I was in trouble. I mean, you have to have qualifications and things to be a nanny. But I just thought, I've been around kids. I grew up in Utah, so I could babysit.
I could do this.
That's how, you know, unknowing I was, naive I was.
Okay. More songs. We'll talk more.
Yeah.
Far Away
yeah.
and Dance Song.
Far Away is, it's a song about gratitude and being on your journey. It's one of my first songs that I wrote when I was in London and really all alone. You know, nobody knew who I was or even cared. So you got thinking about who am I? And Dance Song is the song I wrote thinking about what can I sing the kids? And so that's that.
So they're kind of the impetus for that. That's terrific. We're listening to Wrenne live in studio with a very stripped down version of what often is electronica and pop mixed all together. Here is Far Away and Dance Song.
Change and right, and together with the beat of your heart forever. Like a child, take the chance to feel the beat, to dance, dance. Cross your partner on the right, round and around, hold on tight. La la, la la la. La-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- big hit, four ball change and right, and together with the beat of your heart forever. Like a child, take the chance to feel the beat, to dance, dance, and cross your partner on the right, round and round, hold on tight. La da 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 da.
This is Highway 89. We're listening to Wrenne live in the studio. The songs we just heard, first Far Away and then Dance Song. Wrenne, I think you had to write your own songs eventually because your voice is so flexible. I'm hearing jazz, I'm hearing Latin, I'm hearing musical theater, I'm hearing folk, and we're probably going to hear more other things in the songs to come. I don't know. It seems like you have to do it or you'd get bored stuck in any one of them, I think. Yeah, you talked about the kids, but you were not a nanny forever. In fact, you traded that in for your own child, and you have
That's
a daughter.
Right.
And she seems to appear in a lot of the posts you make on social media, and she seems very interested in doing a lot of the same things that you do. Tell us about that.
Well, I might be brainwashing her to be my best friend. You know, I think
you
that's
must be
more
interested
like,
in the following things.
Just basically need some company. So, no, we do. We do. We have very compatible personalities. And her, well, I guess I can't speak for any other parent and their child, but we do get along really well. Her name, the meaning of Darwin, is dear friend. Mm. And that truly is what she is. She is a dear friend.
Do you find yourself measuring or considering what you want to say to the world in your music, in your art, your stage show, in some ways by what she's listening to, what she will get from you?
For sure. For sure, yes. I want her to grow up discovering her mind and being authentic and to not be afraid and to be courageous and to find her edges.
It seems like she's got a good start on that, at least from what we see.
Thanks.
Now, there's another pair of songs we're going to hear. The first is One More Day, but this is not the entire cast of Les Mis' One More Day.
No.
So please clue us in on this.
It's a song about saying goodbye. Hmm. And this is also one of my very earliest songs when I came to London. The song I'm going to sing after that is called Sorry. It's about saying sorry.
Okay.
It's as clear as that.
We're listening to Wrenne live in studio today on Highway 89. The first piece is One More Day, followed by Sorry.
One last morning to be held. I won't tell, just keep my shaking steady. One more afternoon with you, any place with your embrace, and maybe I'll be ready to remember. Oh, remember. Finally a sunset, warm and calm in your palm. Hold my breath, I'll sit still. If you will, then I think I'll be okay to remember. Remember how it was for us, how you cared for me. Remember you with peace because you had to set me free. We both know. No, 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 no. Even hold my breath, I'll sit still. If you will, hold me for one more day. Hold me. hold me in my own cage of pride here before you. Too humble to hide, please forgive me. Oh, hand me a new heart as I've become stiff, like petrified wood with no way to shift. With this weight that I shouldn't have sworn I could lift, with such form it feels cold and alone. Those words that I said, they were not meant to crush. Well, they only came out because I cared too much. How can you know that you're wrong when you're rushed with this hurry so bold? I have always known. I know I can change. If this fall doesn't kill me, then I'll rearrange the way that I've learned to run in such death as you do when you're running while holding your breath. I was wrong, I was mistaken. Fill my lungs, please awake them. I'm suffocating in my own cage of pride here before you. Too humble to hide, please forgive me. I know I can change. I'm shedding the tears that water the seed that grow me for you, and it's you that I need. You are the sunshine the Londoner longs for. You are, you are, you are. Wrong, I was mistaken. Fill my lungs, please awake them. I'm suffocating in my own cage of pride here before you, and too humble to hide. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Please.
We've just heard a pair of songs from Wrenne live in studio here. First, One More Day, which I have to say is a pretty good, tender, low-key heartbreak song. And sorry, I'm over here going, okay, don't think about it too much. Very nicely done. You know, Wrenne, people who follow you on social media and now people listening heard the intro today. They know you're a songwriter. They know you're a performer. But you have a thing for trampolines, running, and even parkour.
Yeah.
And you're integrating those into your act.
Yeah.
Not satisfied to just stand still with your guitar.
Yes. Well, let's see. Let's see what happens. But I was telling you this in the warm-up as well. It feels like I'm going a bit of a full circle because standing still playing my guitar is how I started as a songwriter. And I created this audience who expected that of me. And I was like a little bit pent up. So collaborating with people who could help me make a sound much bigger than me and then therefore be able to create a show that's much bigger than me has taken me full circle to be able to move around and use lots more tools for storytelling.
Well, I'm excited for this show that's coming.
Me too.
At the Edinburgh Fringe Festival that you'll be doing, and we'll keep our eyes open to see how you do that. But I'm really glad you're willing to share the more pent-up version because that's what's available to us today. These next couple of tunes, one of them is called Running to Orion, which has great imagery to me. I can't wait to hear what it's actually about. Mm. And Dandelion, introduce us to these songs.
Okay, so Running to Orion is actually in this show. It's made it to the show. And it's about, you know, when you're... I know you know how I feel when you're chasing your better self, you're chasing your, whatever you think that is, your soul, maybe. But you're both going to the same place, but you're always one step ahead of yourself, one step behind of yourself. Dandelion is a song about letting go. You know the tradition of blowing on a, make a wish, and then you blow the feathers away. And that inspired this song called Dandelion.
Coming to you live from Studio 6, this is Highway 89. We're listening to singer-songwriter Wrenne, the next couple of songs, Running to Orion, followed by Dandelion.
Destination in yourself, unknown and unexplored. I'd read you from cover to cover. Isn't that what you were running for? Look at you go, so swift. Oh, if only I could see your face. You spiral high and low like a rodeo ship. As if outer space was in you, it's as if you could strip down to the center of your sun. You sail on, you swear you're gonna find your one. How can I keep up with you? I am running to Orion also, but you make me still in my motion with your style and sea. But your back is an ocean, I would dive in deep, yeah. Swallow me all if I could keep up with my soul. You could carry all my failings like a trophy of the past, with a vision for tomorrow and a hand to hold at last. Teach me how to love, who could catch and teach me how to love when I haven't even caught myself? How can I keep up with you? I am running to Orion also, but you make me still in my motion with your style and sea. Back as an ocean and I would dive in deep, yeah. Swallow me all if I could just keep up. You let go, I am a thief. You feel life and I feel grief. You just know and I ask why. You are truth and sometimes I lie.
Thank you.
my seat of worry. As I blow, I feel them go, and the cotton fall before me, floats away as I fall back. I can see what I've become. Don't you know what brought me up? Mistakes, and we have all made some. Dandelion, you make it clear. Clearly, I have been confused for everything that I have found. I shouldn't hesitate to lose. Oh, I can see what I've become. Don't you know what brought me up? Mistakes we have all made. For everything that I have found, don't let me hesitate to lose. Don't let me hesitate to lose. Don't let me hesitate. I wish for everything that I have found, I will not hesitate to lose.
We heard Running to Orion, Dandelion, and I mentioned earlier that Wrenne is preparing a show for the Edinburgh Fringe Festival, which will have a performing show every day during the month of August. Tell me a little bit about the show, because it's not like bring your guitar and sing us a few songs.
Thank goodness. I mean, because I'm not much of a guitarist, as you can tell.
No, I'm quite impressed.
Thanks. But yeah, I'm not so... I will be singing to recorded music that's been worked on by some amazing producers, and with a set and with a trampoline and a platform, and there will be climbing and jumping and dancing and storytelling, and my album will essentially be the soundtrack to a narrative story.
Very exciting. Yeah. I'm so thrilled for you. We are really putting you through your paces today because we want to hear so much music. We're kind of stopping to just chat. Mostly that so you can breathe in for a minute.
Yeah.
But we're done now. We want more music. So introduce us to these next several. I Do, You Are More, and Puzzle Place. By the way, I really love the hook on Puzzle Place. Every time it comes back, it just has that satisfying hit like, oh yeah, this is where I want it to come back to.
Thank you. I Do is also a really early song about devotion. Mm. And You Are More is a song I wrote for my daughter as she was sleeping. I think it's as everything, as all of my songs, including Puzzle Place, everything. It's a prayer. All of my songs are like my prayer. You Are More, though, specifically is for her, but also for me. And same with Puzzle Place. It's a prayer.
Good. We're listening to Wrenne live on Highway 89. We'll start with I Do and You Are More.
With you, your grace and your bride I will be. I will serve you all my days, embrace you for embracing me. I am yours, I am yours. You are mine, you are mine. I'll unlock all my doors, take the space you find. Fill all the space you find. Traveling these ships of dust, I know you know true I must remain. I'll never be through, I've promised me for you. in our union God is found, and that is what I've chosen. Home is where we're bound. Home. Ships of dust, I know you know true, we must remain. I'll never be through, I've promised me for you. I will walk on your water, I will drink from your cup. Thank you forever, I am looking up. I am looking
You're listening to Performances and Conversation with Wrenne. You just heard I Do and You Are More. More music now. Here is Puzzle Place live in studio on Highway 89.
Why don't we take off, join the ones that we love for one day? One day isn't ever enough, but it's gonna be better someday. I am strong. Hold my hand and the sun shines falling down like a waterfall free fall. Summertime looking in your eye telling me that you're gonna stay. I am proud. Take me to the puzzle place. No, I
That's Puzzle Place on Highway 89, always coming to you live. Singer-songwriter Wrenne in the studio today. We have got time for one more tune, but I do want to just ask you a little bit about songwriting. You mentioned, well, I wrote this looking at my daughter while she was sleeping. I wrote this after I got here. Do you write your songs when they kind of are sort of pushing like, hey, I'm ready to be born? Or do you sit down and think, well, it's time that I write, and what shall I write about?
Oh, man. That's the hardest question, Stephen, because at first it's always changing, basically, is the answer. When I started writing songs, they just spilled out of me. Like, that's all I did was just have a pen in my hand and the lyrics just came. When I started collaborating, there was, you know, you go to the studio and then you sit down and you write this song together. Yeah. And then sometimes now, I don't go to the studio very often lately. And so I've just, when it comes, it comes. But the one thing that is always the truth for me is I rarely set out to write a song that I planned to write. Like, I will write the lyrics and then read them and go, oh, that's what I was saying. So it's always after, it's almost like the songs are my teachers. I didn't create them. They're helping to create me.
And isn't that puzzling how that works? Art and the artist who created the piece. Mm. You know, I have to say, because I've had the privilege of seeing you performing at different times in your life, which is sort of like being under a cloudy, you know, seeing a star come through now and then, seeing the moon a little bit. But some of these songs, I feel like we got a cloudless night and we're far away from the city, and I'm getting to see the stars in the Milky Way appear as you kind of grow into who you are artistically. It's really satisfying.
Thanks.
So, this appropriately named the final song, So Goes Time. Will you introduce this to us?
Yeah, this is a song that I have, again, like one of my first songs, and it survived as one that I love to put through my vocal cords. You know, I still love singing it. I don't think I'll ever get sick of singing this song. So I'm really glad I could put it in this set.
We're listening to Wrenne today. Here is our final song.
We're going to hear
So Goes Time. I should mention one of my favorite videos of Wrenne's is Puzzle Place, which has some imagery of light and stars kind of appearing from nowhere. And how is this even happening?
Drip that's turned to spill is how I have come to feel, and the stain you have to laugh at and call history. Oh, so the past is booked like a fish who's been hooked. I can only pray now grace will set me free. You'll go your way, I'll go mine. Day. So goes time. So here I woke up dreaming to the rhythm of your breathing. I gotta say it's not so easy next to you. When the air between us cracks like the eggshells that I've made stacks, all the while I'm stuck on you like super glue, stuck on you. You'll go your way, I'll go mine. Call this a day, so goes time. So soon this one will be done, and it won't be you that makes me cool. Melody of lessons I have got to learn. You'll go your way, I'll go mine.
So Goes Time, coming to you live from Highway 89. We've been listening to Wrenne, that's W-R-E-N-N-E, on Highway 89, sharing new music and some deeper cuts from a catalog filled with ideas about exploration, wonder, and discovery. At least some of the music you heard today is from an upcoming show to be performed at the Edinburgh Fringe Festival, a show called I Said Yes to Everything. Wrenne joins us here in the studio, but lives in the UK, where she continues to blend music, trampolines, parkour, and running. If you just caught part of the show, you'd like to hear the beginning, share it with a friend. All of our shows are archived online for free on-demand listening at byuradio.org/highway89. Follow us on Twitter at BYUH89 for live show updates and special behind-the-scenes photos and video clips. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. Our recording engineer is Mark Waite. Our student assistants are Victoria Khalil and Naomi Campbell. And the show's producer is Sam Payne. I'm Stephen Cap Perry. Thanks for listening.